Greetings. I wanted to continue examining Islam's basic problems of logic. Who did God make his covenant with? Ishmael or Isaac? The existence of the question highlights something of interest. God's covenant is a fighting matter. Satan clearly thinks God's covenant is worth fighting against. We should know it is worth fighting to obtain. One who has the covenant will have God's support, his blessing, his fatherly guidance, and protection. One who does not have the covenant will want it. So how do we even know such a covenant exists? It is recorded in the Torah, in the book of Genesis. Who recorded the Torah? Prophet Moses recorded most of the Torah. Genesis 17:15. God also said to Abraham, "As for Sarai, your wife, you are no longer to call her Sarai. Her name will be Sarah. I will bless her and will surely give you a son by her. I will bless her so that she will be the mother of nations. Kings of peoples will come from her." This is speaking of Sarah. Abraham fell face down. He laughed and said to himself, "Will a son be born to a man 100 years old? Will Sarah bear a child at the age of 90? And Abraham said to God, "If only Ishmael might live under your blessing." There is no question that Ishmael existed. And there is no question Abraham loved Ishmael as his son. But God is God, O Muslim. Then God said, "Yes, but your wife Sarah will bear you a son, and you will call him Isaac. I, God, will establish my covenant with him as an everlasting covenant for his descendants after him." This is God talking. This is Prophet Moses revealing what God said to Abraham. God said he would make his eternal covenant with Isaac. And as for Ishmael, this is still God talking. God acknowledges Ishmael. Ishmael does, in fact, exist. And God has something to say to Abraham about Ishmael. "As for Ishmael, I have heard you. I will surely bless him. I will make him fruitful and will greatly increase his numbers. He will be the father of 12 rulers, and I will make him into a great nation." Sadly, the descendants of Ishmael only care about this one verse. But after saying this, God is still talking. But God is still talking. God has just finished saying he would bless Ishmael. Ishmael will not be abandoned and forgotten by God Almighty. But my covenant I will establish with Isaac, whom Sarah will bear to you by this time next year. It is a gross disregard for Almighty God to ignore God's full statement. This is the tragic desperation and jealousy of Islam manifest in absolute clarity. "But my covenant I will establish with Isaac, whom Sarah will bear to you by this time next year." God's word is absolutely clear. "And as for Ishmael, I have heard you. I will surely bless him. I will make him fruitful and will greatly increase his numbers. But my covenant I will establish with Isaac." The very same message. Adjacent words of the same thought. God declared His covenant would be with Isaac, who did not yet exist. And there is a reason God made this declaration: to prove he is God and not a demonic voice in a cave. In fact, Sarah laughed at God's claim. Sarah knew her body had stopped functioning as a woman. Genesis 18:10. Then one of them said, "I will surely return to you about this time next year, and Sarah, your wife, will have a son." Now Sarah was listening at the entrance of the tent, which was behind him. Abraham and Sarah were already very old, and Sarah was past the age of childbearing. So Sarah laughed to herself as she thought, "After I am worn out and my Lord is old, will I now have this pleasure?" Then the Lord said to Abraham, "Why did Sarah laugh and say, 'Will I really have a child now that I am old?'" Holy crap, Batman! Sarah found God's promise to be laughable. Unbelievable. Then the Lord said to Abraham, "Why did Sarah laugh and say, 'Will I really have a child now that I am old?'" Remember, this is Yahweh, maker of heaven and earth. And the wife of his friend Abraham has just laughed at him. "Not sure I would have the balls to do that," laugh at God. "And I'm not sure God didn't kick in the reverb and drop his voice an octave when he answered. Maybe even a little lip snarl and glare from under his hood. Is anything too hard for the Lord? I will return to you at the appointed time next year, and Sarah will have a son. So, go get busy, Abraham." Sarah was afraid. So she lied and said, I did not laugh." But he, God, said, "Yes, you did laugh." Holy crap, Batman! Face to face with God and she lies. Without doubt, God is meek and self-controlled. So the same God that foretold a son in just a year to a barren old woman, the God that rather pointedly said, "Is there anything too hard for me?" He specifically mentions Ishmael and then contramands any confusion. "But my covenant I will establish with Isaac, whom Sarah will bear to you by this time next year." And yet Islam does not want to accept God's word. Islam wants to believe the promise to Ishmael, one verse, smack dab in the middle between two verses that damn their claim. But logic is not yet through. Let us play along with Islam and imagine Ishmael did have the covenant and not just a promise. "Nor wast thou at the side of the mountain of Tur when we called to Moses. Yet art thou sent as mercy from thy Lord to give warning to a people to whom no warner had come before thee, in order that they may receive admonition." Surah 28:46. This is speaking about Muhammad. "Or do they say he has forged it? Nay, it is the truth from thy Lord, that thou mayest admonish a people to whom no warner has come before thee, in order that they may receive guidance." Surah 32:3. "They swore their strongest oaths by Allah, that if a warner came to them, they would follow his guidance better than any other of the peoples. But when a warner came to them, it has only increased their flight from righteousness." Surah 35:42. So according to Islam, Ishmael got the covenant, which then went over 2,000 years without a single messenger from Allah. While all the prophets of God, who worked miracles and signs and wonders, went to Israel. I guess they got lost. The Messiah, the Holy One of God, was sent to Israel, who did not have the covenant. Huh. So what value was this covenant in all pragmatic reality? God seeks Israel. God woos Israel. God calls Israel back to repentance by the prophets. And Islam wants to claim Isaac does not have the covenant with God. Logically, the existence of the covenant with God, by God, is proven by God's involvement, by God's behaviors, by God's actions, by God delivering Israel from Egypt, and inversely, by Satan's hatred for the Jews. Even if one decides to ignore the text of the Torah and Bible, the realities of history and even modern Israel overwhelmingly prove who has the covenant with Almighty God. And he who denies it denies logic and the facts of history. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.